Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy. In today's workshop, we're going to be talking about complex vectors and making complex shapes in just a matter of seconds. And on another platform, I was asked by a member, I do most of my own graphics, and one of the other members asked me if I could make an infinity shape with the all CNI in the middle. So I went ahead and did it for them. And I just wanted to take a minute and cover these complex vectors and show you just how easy they are to make. So with that, let's get started. Now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab an ellipse. I'll hold down shift so that I can make a circle. And then I'll select that circle. And what I'm going to do is press Control D to get a perfect copy of it. And if you saw there, the line turned black, which meant that I had a perfect copy. So I'm going to move this halfway off. I know it's halfway off because I can see the center of it right here, touching the outside line of the circle. Now, if you look here, you'll see that this is animated all the way around, which means that it is selected. This one is not, which means that it's not selected. So I'm going to press Control D one more time. Now you see it turn black. That means that I made the duplicate, and I'm using my arrow keys to accurately move it instead of using the mouse. Now I've got this one on top of here, and what I'm going to do is actually move this one further out. Oh, I'm sorry, right there. Okay, so now I've got these two. I'm going to press Control D one more time, and I'm going to move this one out. And now I've got four fairly accurate circles. And now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come up to the polygon, grab it. I'm going to press the shift key again so that I make a perfect polygon. And then I'm going to come over here to shape properties on the right side of the screen. And right here where it says sides, we're going to make a triangle. Just lower that to 3. And then we'll press the escape key. Actually, I'm just going to hit the selector up here. Now with it selected, I'm going to press either the period or the comma key just to get it to flip. I'm going to use the period key. I'm flipping it twice. And now I have it straight up and down. You could use up here in the top, you could just go to rotate. But the period or the comma key, period moves it to the right, comma moves it to the left. It's just easier to use. So I'm going to take this one and I'm going to snap it up in here somewhere. You see how it snaps into different places? I think I'm going to snap it right about there. And that snapped right in the middle of these two. And I'm going to hit Control and D again. And you see I have my duplicate. And I'm just going to move this one over here. Now, this is not a particular project. I'm just going to do whatever there was. Snap that one in place and just move it up a hair. Right about there. Looks good. This is not a particular project that I'm doing here, but it's just to give you an example. And the next thing I'm going to do is just select all of them. Now, you see how I have the green selector? So I don't necessarily have to go across everything here like you do with the red selector. If you go on the right side of the image, all you have to do is touch the images. It selects all of them. If you go on the left side, you see we have the red selector. You have to actually select all of the images. It's a specific selector. So we're just going to do the green, select everything here, and we're going to come down here and create a circular array. We have two array tools here. We could create an array of in a grid, or we can create a circular array. Now for these complex shapes, and a lot of people like to call them infinity shapes, the circular array tool is going to do this in just a few seconds or 1 second. Watch what happens when I click on this. You see that? It made the entire array, and you can adjust over here where it says copies, the number of copies that you want. So we're going to leave this at 30. And say OK. Come back to Cuts and Layers. Make sure this is on Fill. And I know this doesn't look like a lot right now, but if we take a preview up here on top, you can see that we have what we're looking for. Now, I know this is not actually the all-seeing eye, but it sort of looks like it. I don't know. What do you think? Let me know in the comments down below. But this is just a beautiful array that you can burn on anything. And it's quick and easy. And I've seen a lot of tutorials online where people are just spending lots of time trying to create these. And there's no reason for it. If we just use this array tool, it makes life so much easier. And let me show you something that's even more fun. So if we were to come back to our original template, now we have our circles and we have our triangles. So let's go ahead and click on this one, come over to Shape Properties, over here on the right, click on that, power scale this to 100%. This one's good, 100%. Let's click on the next one, and you'll see again it's animated. We know it's clicked on. Let's power scale this one to 25%. And this one we'll leave at 100, and this one we'll also put at 25%. Now let's get this one, should be 100, it is, and let's put this one at 50. I'm just picking an arbitrary number here. So now we have all different power scales here. And if we look at this, you'll see it makes for a really interesting modern shape. But what's even more interesting is if we come down here to the array tool and create this array and preview that. Look at how beautiful that is. Now this will burn at different levels. And that's how you'll get the different colors. We have different percentages, different burn levels. And you could even go a step further and put every one of them on a different layer. So this is just a quick video today. And we're going to do one or two more just for fun. And we're going to use the undo up here. And we will go ahead and get rid of these guys here. And it doesn't matter what shape that you use. So I like to mix up shapes when I do these arrays. So let's grab a rectangle. Let's draw out a perfect rectangle here. And let's make it just a little bit bigger. I hit control instead of shift that time, which is why it jumped all over the place. All right, so we've got one there. And then I'm going to hit the circle, press shift, because I do want a circle this time. And then I'll hit the polygon, press shift, draw a perfect polygon. And actually, I'm going to get rid of this one because I really did want a square. So let's get rid of that. Let's press shift and draw out a square. And now we have just three basic shapes. And what I'm going to do is we're going to have four basic shapes. So again, we'll take this one here. We'll come over here and make it three-sided so that it's a triangle. And then I'll go ahead and press the period key twice again, flip it over like so. Or maybe I'll just press the comma key and put it back sideways like so. It doesn't really matter what you do. It's fun to experiment with this. So now I'll grab this one and overlap it here. I'm going to grab this one and overlap it here. And you don't have to snap it in. None of this has to be perfect. This is just a fun tool to play with. And that looks good to me. So I'm just going to drag over it, come to the array tool. And in the array tool, you always want it to start at 0, end at 360. That's a full circle. And everything else you can just leave the way it is. So now I have 29 copies. Let's move this up and make it even more intricate at 34 and take a preview. And look how cool that looks. I mean, this is really a very cool infinity circle here. What do you think? I mean, these are so easy to do, yet nobody seems to be doing them. They're going into Photoshop, and they're going into all these other programs and creating these complicated shapes when it's so easy to do in Lightburn. Now for fun, let's go ahead, grab our selector tool. Let's get rid of these two, just for fun. We're gonna go ahead and delete those. Let's take this one, press Control D to duplicate it. Then we're gonna come up here. We're going to select it, come up here, and we're going to mirror it like so. Now with my mouse keys, I'm going to move it off so that it just barely touches right there in the middle. This one, we're going to grab it by the middle so we have our snap guides and let it snap. See it snap into place there in the middle? We're going to snap it into place in the middle. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to Control D, duplicate it one more time. I'm going to move it off. I'm going to press my comma key so that it turns to the left. Grab it by the middle and put it right there. Now I'll press Control D again. I'm going to move that one off. And I'm just using my arrow key right now. I'm going to, up here, I'm going to vertically flip this one. Move it back up to the middle here. And let's just see what we get when we do this. Now, I've never done this one before. It looks like it could be fun. So let's grab those. Let's do the array. Say OK and preview it. And look at that. Look at what a beautiful pattern this makes. And yeah, it may not be perfect everywhere. You have your triangle in the middle, you know, but it's still a beautiful, beautiful pattern. And like I said, you can do this with any shape that you want. And I know you guys are used to the long-winded tutorials. But today is short, and I just wanted to cover this with you and show you how easy it is to make these complex shapes in just a few seconds. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.